forgets about his intelligence or about his knowledge, and he misuses it for his personal gains, right? And how one by one he just enters into this world of lawlessness. And although he's a very good scientist, but he's not a good human being. So it is required. So both things are required, isn't it? Right. So if you have some kind of a qualification, if you have some kind of extra knowledge or a post and all, it is also important that you be a good human being. Okay. And yes, so you don't, lose your basic qualities. Fine. Yes. What happened in the end of the story? What did Griffin do? What did he do to... So he removes his clothes, he tries to escape. Was he able to escape? Who had come to catch him? The constable was there. Jaffers was the constable. Yes, Mr. Jaffers was there. And Mrs. Hall was very surprised to see the furniture moving. And when the man comes out, and so she tells him that you were not here. And everybody suspects him that he's the one who's committed the robbery at the which place? Wait, whose house? Vicar. Right at the Vicar's house, that he's the one who has committed the robbery over there. And he has to be caught. And people call the police. And but Griffin runs away. Right? So he removes his bandages and clothes, and he even injures the constable. Okay? Right. So now I'm going to ask you a few questions from this chapter. Now, can you just tell me that why were the boys surprised to see a barefooted man? Did they see the barefooted man? No. How do they know that man was barefooted?
By seeing his footprints.
And anyway, why was it so surprising for a person to be barefooted over there? Because it was cold and it was raining. And what made the footprints visible? The rain, isn't it? So the rain there, the mud, and because of that, the wet feet. So they were making the footprints. Otherwise, no one would have come to know that there was an invisible person. And that is how he was able to make his presence felt. Okay. Now, what do you think the boys must have felt when they saw those footprints? They must be amazed. They might be surprised. They're also confused. Yes, they could be confused also. Let's see, there are footprints over here, but there's no person here. And so where are these footprints coming from? Okay, so they could be confused also. Now, Griffin was a brilliant scientist. How can we say that?
Due to his
discovery of, invisibility and he was successful. Do you think he was successful in that? Yes, but what was one problem about his invisibility that he did not think about? He can't be visible again? Yes, and what else did he not think about? Yes? Yeah, so if he wears clothes, then again he will become visible. But then his body, because he cannot make his body completely visible again, right? He could not reverse that invisibility. That is something that he could not do. Then he did not think about that. See, even if I become invisible, I'm going to feel hungry. I'm going to feel cold. I'll need a place to live in, right? I'll need money to survive. Yes? So these are the things that he did not think about. He was a brilliant scientist. He was able to do his, research and work and everything. But he was not, as a good human being. Okay? Fine. Now, how did he reach the position of invisibility? How did he become invisible? What did he do? Yes, so he consumed certain rare drugs, right? Yes, so he did. He discovered the formula of invisibility. And then he thought about that, what could he do to become invisible, right? So he took these drugs and he became invisible himself, okay? So it like, yes, how does one come to this kind of a conclusion? You know, like, do you think it was an easy task to become invisible? Would it have taken a long time? Yes, it would have taken a long time to do that, isn't it? Right? And yes, yeah, it is, you know, because he had to see which drugs were successful, which were not. All those things he had to see, right? And then taking those drugs, and he, first of all, he performed the experiment, as I told you, on a cat also, right, on a piece of wool, and then he tried it on himself. But one problem he had was that he could not reverse this invisibility. Yes, now why, who was Griffin disliked by? His landlord did not like him. What about Mrs. Hall's behavior towards Griffin? She was suspecting him. In the beginning, she was very kind and she was very happy because in this winter, they have a customer, right? It's not easy to find people coming there during the winter. So she's happy to find one. And but later on, when he keeps on delaying the payment, and then later on, when he is there, you know, like not there in the room, and all of a sudden he comes in the room, then she starts suspecting him. Yes, so he arranged money by stealing, and he was always delay about his payment, that I'm waiting for some money and all that stuff. Okay, fine. Now, why was Griffin wandering on the streets? Why was Griffin on the streets? Why was he wandering on the streets? Because what had he done? He lost it. No, what had he done to his house? Burnt it. He set fire to it. Yes, he burnt his house and he's doing the action, you know, like you have to think, what did he do? Very nice. Okay, so he burnt the house and that is why he was wandering on the streets and he did not have any home. So a brilliant scientist becoming homeless. Who was responsible for this? Griffin himself, because of his nature, because he was very, short-tempered and he was a little eccentric also, right? Yes. Fine. Now, what do you think is the main theme of this story? What is the theme or the idea of this story? What is it? You make yourself invisible. Then... think before you act, is it? Or what else? What is the more important, being a good scientist or a good human being? Yes, right. It could be that. Could be that. Yes, right. And of course, should one misuse one's powers?
No,
we should not misuse our powers. We should be good citizens always. We should not try to break any kind of law and order, even if you are the most powerful person. You should not break laws. Okay. Now, yes, we've read about that, why it was a bad time for Griffin to be in London, because it was the middle of winter, it was snowing, and it was a rainy day, and that time, so walking around there. Okay. Now, which place, say, was the theatrical store? Which area was that theatrical store? Do you remember the name of the place? Which places do you have to remember when you do this chapter? One is London. He left London. Then he went to Iping, the village. Yes. In London, where did he go? He went to the store first. Then he went to which place? The costume shop. Right. And where was that costume shop? That is Drury Lane. That's a very, very important place for... theatrical costumes. Okay, so which place is it? Remember this, Drury Lane. And what did he do over there? What did he do in Drury Lane? So he bandaged his face, he put a false nose, whiskers and all, he put a hat, right? And that was to cover his eyes and all, and he wore sunglasses. So all these things he got from there. And what did you do before leaving? What did you do there before leaving? You just went out normally? Well, okay, now I'm disguised. Nobody can recognize me. I can leave. What did he do to the owner of the shop? Killed. He injured him. He hurt him. And the man became unconscious. And what did he do? He stole money. Right? And he came out of that place. Okay? Fine. So see, his lawlessness, it began right from his landlord's house. He put the house on fire. Then he went to the store. He wanted to steal things. But why was he unsuccessful over there? Because he was caught by the people there. They came and they saw this man sleeping around. And they, you know, like chased him. And he took off his clothes one by one. And he had to go out once again. Then he went to Drury Lane, which is a theatrical lane. And there he got all the accessories. And he got the clothes. And while leaving also, what did he do to the owner? He injured him. And he also stole the money. Then he went to Iping or Iping. And there he had a room, and the villagers are very curious about him. Mrs. Hall also quite happy that the person is there. Okay, fine. Yes. Now, why did Griffin wear bandages? What did he want to outline? Because when he wore the suit, what was still invisible? His head, neck, face, all that. Yeah, it was invisible. So when he wore the bandages, what was he outlining? His face, right? So the bandages outlined his face and the suit outlined his body, right? His torso and his legs, okay? Now, so how do you think he would have looked like? He looked like a young person? He looked like a scary person? A person with bandages on his face? Looked like an injured person, okay? Very nice. And that is what he told others also, that he had met with an accident, right? Now, why did Griffin pretend that he would get money soon? That is what he was telling his landlady also, that I'm getting money soon. Why was he pretending? Because he was not having money and he was waiting that somehow I could get some money, you know, like because he had left his home and all everything. And so he did not have money to survive. So he was pretending that he's going to get some kind of payment. So the lady would not send him out. If the lady threw him out of that hotel also, where was he going to live? Right? So you might get some question maybe as a picture also. So you would be able to identify, okay, that what it looks like. Now, why did the clergyman and his wife, why did they go downstairs? Why did they go downstairs then? They heard a noise, the clergyman and his wife. We're not talking about Mr. and Mrs. Hall. Clergyman came. What happened in his house? What happened in the clergyman's house? A robbery happened. But what was so strange about that? They heard some noise, but they could not see anyone, right? They heard the coins also. They heard the sound also, but they did not could see anybody over there. Okay? Right. Now, why did Mrs. Hall felt that the room was haunted by spirits? Yes, because the chair was moving and haunted, right? What is haunted here? Haunted means scary? Or why does it become scary? What makes it scary, haunted? When you talk about a haunted house.
No one is here.
So who's moving the things? This is Griffin, but otherwise we talk about haunted places.
No,
then who moves those places? Supernatural. We talk about ghosts and spirits, isn't it? So when we talk about haunted, it means that some supernatural power is there, right? And some, you know, mysterious element there, some ghost or spirit or something. And they are making that thing move, okay? Right? So yes, yeah, so it is right, not quite a nice thing. So what had made it haunted? What made the chair haunted? Griffin made the chair haunted. Yes. And why? What did Mrs. Hall think? Why is the chair moving? Because it belonged to her mother, that chair. And now she's wondering that some, who's done these strange things to her furniture? Griffin. Okay. And so it is moving. Yes. Now, right. Next is, let us just discuss thief story. Can you do thief story? Yes. So let's do thief's story. And what do we know about the thief? What's his name? Hari Singh. Who did he work for? Anil. And why did he choose Anil? Because he seemed to be a nice person. And who do you think was more clever, Anil or Hari Singh? Hari was more clever. And yes, and do you think Hari lied to Anil? When he wanted to take up a job, he lied to him? Yes, he told him that he knew how to cook, but he did not. No. Yes, so he was very bad at cooking, but even then Anil kept him and did not send him away. Right? And what did Anil promise to do?
To teach him.
Yes. Yes, to teach him how to write. And what did Anil do for his living? He was a writer. And yes, so one day Anil got a lot of money. How? Yes, his book was sold to the publisher and the publisher gave him money. Yes, Bhavin, can you give me the answer? Yes, then do speak up, okay? Don't sit there looking so sleepy and lazy. Right, so he gave the book, got the money. And of course, we all know what Hari Singh did with that. Hari Singh stole the money, right? And yes, why? He was there quite an expert. It seems that this is not the first time that Hari Singh has committed a crime. How do we know that? Yes, what are the things that tell us that, see, Hari has committed crimes before us. He has changed his name. Very nice. What else? He was a good observer. He could immediately, you know, assess, right, as he says, that the poor man accepts his fate. Right? Resignation is what? Acceptance. Fine. Got this question. And there was a little bit of mistakes here. So he thought that, yes, and what about the rich man? That's angry, right? Because I worked so hard. And someone has taken away my money, right? So the poor man thinks that, okay, what can I do if he's helpless? And what did Hari Singh observe about Anil? That he's careless and he's not worried about things. And do you think the money, you know, like, was it he stole it only once or he had been stealing before also? How? When? Yes. So when he went to the market and when, you know, Anil would give him money for the daily shopping and all, what would he do? Would keep some with him. Yes, and he would not give all of the money, right? And yeah, so it was there that this was not the first time. Every day he was cheating him. Do you think Anil was aware of what this boy was doing?
Yes, about market.
About the market, he was aware because he knew that this is what I was spending earlier. And now where is that money going? Now about the final robbery that he committed. Then why didn't Hari Singh not run away? He had the opportunity, he had the money, everything. Could have gone away. Why didn't he? So, but he was cheating every day. Then why didn't he think about that? That's why he didn't go? Then what did he think about it? What made him decide? He didn't want to get charged or he didn't want to break his trust. But he's already broken his trust. He's gone away. What if Anil had found out? What if Anil had complained about him? Right? Then? So do you think what Hari Singh did was right? Was he right in his decision to come back?
Yes.
And what about Anil? Do you think he's aware that his money has been stolen?
Yes, because it was
wet. It was wet because of the rain. And when he would have seen the money, he would have noticed that it is wet. The notes are damp. And yeah, right. So, yes. So he would have realized that he has stolen his money. Okay. And yes. So let's just see if we can do a few questions. Now, Anil looked easygoing, kind and simple to the narrator. Who's the narrator here? The thief, Hari Singh, is the narrator. Now, which of the given characteristics would not fit in with this description? Which characteristics of Anil? Was he compassionate? Was he suave? Was he uncomplicated? Or was he carefree? Which one is not there? What is suave? Phir carefree kaise keh rahe ho? Huh? How are you saying that? Because we don't know what it means. So suave is someone who is very sophisticated and very confident and all. So was Anil like that? No. So this is the quality. Sometimes ignorance also helps. See, you didn't know this. So you could easily say, okay, I don't know this. And it could be this only his quality. Because yeah, he is compassionate, right? He is uncomplicated. He's carefree. He's not bothered about his money. He's not bothered about others. Isn't it right? So yeah, so suave could have been there. Based on the line, a little flattery helps in making friends. What does this mean? A little flattery helps in making friends. Helps. How? What is flattery? You steal and you make friends with others? False praise. Flattery is false praise. Does it help you in making friends? People become happy when you praise them. Ma'am, you are my favorite teacher. And you say that to everyone. Ma'am, we missed you so much. And you say that to everybody. Isn't it? Ma'am, you're the best. And you say that to everyone. And you think, oh, ma'am is going to give me more marks because I said that. So is flattery something good or bad? So sometimes, you know, when you want to encourage someone, right? Someone is not so confident and not, even at that time, if you're able to praise that person, even false, right? So many times our parents do that. Supposing you might have tried your hand at cooking during the pandemic and you made the worst thing ever. But even then, you know, like, yeah, your parents would have said, oh, it's nice. Try better next time. Okay. So, right. So then that is there. Like, of course, it's a little encouragement. And sometimes they lie also to us to make us feel happy, good, better. Okay? So what transformed the personality of Hari Singh? Which quality of Anil transformed Hari Singh? So quality of Anil. Was it his honesty? Was it his kindness? Was it his empathy? Or was it his humbleness? Kindness, yes. What is empathy, I have told you? Yes, so I have told you again. See, empathy and sympathy, we generally compute. I said empathy and you immediately said pity. So, right, empathy is you understand. Truly understand someone's condition. And sympathy means, yeah, you're feeling sorry about his condition. Oh my God, it's very sad that you fell down and you fractured your leg and all that stuff. You'll get better. Take rest. That we all say that. But empathizing is, yeah, you know, I also fell down and broke my leg. I know how much it hurts. I know how difficult it is, right? Or that is empathy. Fine? So empathy is not relevant here. It is kindness. So every time your ignorance is not going to help you. Yeah, any questions, Shantanu? Now, Hari Singh felt guilty. Why did Hari Singh felt guilty? Because he stole the money from Anil. He broke the trust of Anil. He was not kind like Anil. He was kind like Anil. Hari Singh was kind. Then he was kind. Kind, so that was kind. I'm giving you money back. Take it. I'm so kind. Then? He broke his trust, isn't it, right? So why did he feel guilty? Because, yeah, he stole the money also. He broke the trust also. Right. Now, my spirits rose. But when I took the note, I saw it was still wet from the night's rain. Today, we'll start writing sentences, he said. He knew. But neither his lips nor his eyes showed anything. I smiled at Anil in my most appealing way, and the smile came by itself without any effort. यानी कि अभी तक whatever he was doing, it was all pretense. It was all pretense, you know, like he was there, okay, trying to be nice to, you know, Anil, and trying to help him and trying to make a, you know, like food for him or whatever, or keeping his house clean. But that time, when he saw that Anil had noticed the money is wet, but even then he said that we are going to start writing. He realized that, yes, this boy tried to steal my money. And that is, you know, like, of course, it was a sigh of relief for Hari Singh, because now he realized that, yes, I have to be a good person. I cannot go on breaking the trust of this person. Do you think Hari Singh will steal again?
No.
Will not steal again because he has learned a lesson, yes, right? He's learned that he's because he's come across a good person, someone who's very good at heart also. Okay. Yes. Now, yeah, once again, what do you think is the main idea of this story, thief story? What's the main idea? Yes? To be trustworthy, right? So if you are dishonest, can you be happy? No. We have to steal. It's an important part of our life. Yes? Then helping others is very important. Right? But here, yes, here also it is. Yeah, helping others is also very important. That is what Anil did. He helped this young boy. But if we are dishonest and if we cheat people who are kind to us, we cannot be happy. Okay? Right? Yes. So where did Hari go to then after stealing the money? Yes, to catch the train to Lucknow. And yes, so here it was raining and it was late at night and the station was empty. It was deserted, right? Akela, lonely, you know, there not many people. See, deserted means less number of people. Okay. He deserted me in my time of need. Left me, right? Yes, yeah, so the captain deserted the sinking ship. Left the ship, right? Okay, so yeah, there's a lot of sand in the middle of the desert. This is entirely different. Yes, so he felt scared on the deserted platform, empty platform, okay? So it could be, yeah, because it's the time of the night, it's quite late, it's less trains are coming and going over there. That is why it was deserted. But generally at late night also, we have a lot of crowd, we have a lot of rush. But here it is, yes, there were less people. Okay, yeah. Yeah, what was the name of the shop? The sweet shop?
Jamna
Station.